hate recording during the day because there is so much noise around. There are people talking and crows cawing or crowing. What do they do? And cars honking and gates opening and closing and a lot of noise. There's like mixer grinders going on at the back. So yeah, it's distracting and see? Yeah, it's distracting. And not only that, it's just that, you know, you're very conscious of whether my voice is audible enough, whether you know, the outside disturbances are hampering the focus of the audience, or, you know, sometimes your voice gets drowned in the outside voice, like the outside noise of things. So yeah, I mostly shoot at night, like in the dead of the night when everybody's sleeping. It's so quiet, it's so peaceful, and I can shoot as much as I want till morning and then I go to sleep. And it's feasible to do that in on the weekends, because yeah, when else will you do it? People tell me that I tend to move a lot when I'm sitting idle, but do I do that in videos? I don't think I do that in videos because I'm so busy talking that I don't get bored. Also guys, I noticed that my hair in the last video was really crazy. I mean, like, I get it, this is not tamed, but my last video, like the last haul video and one more I shot, I think I was filming the new year makeup look. Yeah, I was filming the new year makeup look and my hair looks so bad. And so, I mean, I didn't do anything, I didn't, like, I tried to straighten it a little but it didn't work. It was looking really frizzy and dry and weird, and it just wasn't getting straight enough, and I was just like ruining my hair further. So I just let it be and I just brushed it and tried to tame it as much as I could, but my hair looked like, oh my god, what a mess. And I realized that it was probably because of the new shampoo that I switched to. So I switched to the new Pantene Anti Dandruff shampoo. It's still looking quite bushy. Do I look like Hermione? I don't know. Is this what she looked like in the book? Because in the movie she had amazing beautiful curls. I'm diverting from the topic. Hey guys, so I'm back with another haul, and this is the second part of my previous winter haul. And I had asked you guys for suggestions on lip balms because I had posted a picture on Instagram with super dry lips and I really needed lip balms which are super moisturizing and hydrating and all of that. So you guys suggested the Sebamed and the Body Shop Vitamin E lip balm. So yeah, a lot of you suggested that. So I got this one first and this one as well. I'm gonna, you know, wait for it to work its charm. I'm gonna give it some time. I'm gonna give it like at least a week and try both of them out and see how they're working, and finally give my review in the Products Hits and Misses 8th version. Remember guys how in the last haul I had ordered for the small Batiste dry shampoo, and the moment I ordered that, the offer came of 1+1, and I was like, what? Like, I should have waited to order mine. But anyway, I ordered these two. This is the one in blush, and I wanted to order it since a long time, but it was out of stock, the smaller one, and I wanted to try the smaller one first and see how they fared, and then, you know, commit to a bigger packaging. And also I think smaller things are easier to carry if you're traveling or if you're going out somewhere, just to keep in your bag if you have oily hair, you know, so keep it in your work bag if you have to go for a meeting or something like that. And it's so easy and it's just one spray and, you know, you're done. So I got these two, and so far they smelled really mild and I like it that way, because the Be Blunt one kind of smelled really strong for me and it didn't smell nice at all. So yeah, these I like, I don't mind these at all. And lastly, I got the Nivea Oil and Lotion Argan Nourish for dry to very dry skin. This is argan and jojoba oil, and it's got these things, sticky things on it, because there was this tiny Nivea cream free with this, which I gave to my mom because she loves that and I hate it. It's too sticky for me, and the smell is so annoying, because when I was a kid, my mom would forcefully just put it all over my body and my face and everything, because I always had really dry skin, especially in winters. And oh my god, I hated that. It was so sticky and just terrible. So yeah, no. So I got this one. It was kind of a, you know, risk, because I don't really like Nivea body lotions as such. I mean, they all smell the same and everything, but when I saw argan oil and I saw dry to very dry skin, I don't know why, I think I was really lured to buy it, and I was probably PMSing. I don't know, because when I'm PMSing, I buy it really crap stuff. Like, I buy anything. I have no control over myself. So I need a second opinion for someone to tell me that no, don't buy that, wait for it. And this was kind of an impulse buy, but so far, guys, I smelled it and I applied it a little, and so far I really, really like it. And now to the final announcement, guys. I was really, really, really dying to share this with you guys, because in the last haul, as I mentioned, that I bought the Olay, and I had a confusion because the packaging looked really different. I'll show you here. This was the packaging, and it looked really, really different than the one that I had, or the one that that is sold in the market. I got this online, and I mean, the printing, not the packaging, in terms of the bottle and everything is the same, but the printing is quite different, and all of that. So I sent it to Olay, and I sent all the pictures to PNG with details of everything, and I sent it to PNG, and I waited for their revert on the same to know whether it's a genuine product or not, because I put in the barcode in their website and the product didn't show up, so I was a little more concerned. And since it's a skincare product and it doesn't come cheap or anything, and even if it did, it's just your hard-earned money, you don't want to be, you know, duped. So I sent it to them, and they reverted to me saying that it is an original product. Now what happened was that the products that are sold online, at least the two I got one from Amazon and one from Nykaa, and I didn't disclose the name in the previous video because I didn't want to you know, bad mouth anybody without knowing the facts. I didn't want to you know, say that these companies don't sell genuine products, so that's the reason I didn't say their names out. But yeah, now that they're clear, when I ordered from Nykaa the second time, I was dead sure that, you know, it won't be fake, because I mean, so many people buy from there and everything, and it's one of the, you know, leading sellers and stuff, so like leading makeup and beauty and stuff seller online. So I was like, you know, how can they do this? And that's the reason I sent to Olay, and I was so happy to know that, you know, it's a genuine product. There were like a few concerns, as I told you, the printing is a little off, the printing is very off, in fact. The Olay did not have a registered trademark symbol on it, and also the consistency is a little different. So I thought I'm being biased, and I'm, you know, because I'm being too finicky, because I'm already on a high alert mode. So I made my friend try it out, and I made my mom try it out and stuff, just to see that if they felt the difference, and they did feel a slight difference. So the one that is made in India and that was being sold online, is a little thinner when you apply it. And I don't mean that the other one that is being sold in the market is made in Thailand, which has the golden big seven on it. So those are made in Thailand, and the thing is that when you see the product online, they are all the pictures are there of the made in Thailand one, and when you get the product, you get the one which is made in India. Now this is something that Olay and the online companies should take care of, because it really leads to confusion for someone who doesn't pay attention as much to things, it may not bother you. But since I've been using it since a while now, the packaging and everything is kind of, you know, in your head. So like a first look and you go like, okay, this looks, something's different about it. And when I compared it, I realized that, you know, it was quite different in terms of printing. So I feel that the online companies and PNG should take care of this, that, you know, when they're selling something, they should mention these things to avoid confusion. If you're selling a product, they should put the picture of this Olay with the box of that this came in than the one that is sold in the market, because, you know, you're showing me something but you're selling me something else. Of course it's a genuine product, but still, you know, it matters and people get confused like that. So guys, this was my haul and update on the Olay. I really wanted to update you guys so that not to create a panic situation anywhere, and I'm happy that it came out positive. And if you guys want to share anything with me, comment down below. If you have any requests for me, comment down below and let me know, and I'll see you in the next one. Then take care, bye bye.